So it's Monday, half 12. I'm just having my snap on my own today again. Dean's back tomorrow. This will be like a weekly vlog again. I am not geared up at the moment to do multiple videos per week. I just find it easier just doing one. I might add some running clips into some of these videos. So yeah, I'm going back up on my plot now. I've had to go around and put across a plot around a few of my first lifts because the safety decker wanted me to do it. Like, it didn't technically need doing, but they said they need an extra across a plot around them all. So just got to do what you get told at the end of the day. So I'm gonna go around. I'm gonna do a back corner now. My same little technique I did yesterday with the little build up, like a little three course corner, and then run it out, and then rack back. I think that's what I'm going to do. Build everything in little sections with these dry clay bricks.
Thank you. So it's about 4:15. I'm going to load out for a bit. I've got 2 packs of bricks on my loading bay. Dean says he's coming back tomorrow, so I've got him this little panel to run in. I've set up a little corner. I'll show you now. So I've just done that corner round, and I've tailed it right down to that internal as well to make sure it was nice and straight. So he's got this to run in, about a 300 brick section tomorrow. So that'll be his job. He'll just do that and then show you what I'm doing. I've got this pack of bricks to move and that one. So I'm going to set, I've got that profile set already. I'm going to set one there. Let's go all the way around here. Set one there and set one there. So it's just gone 5. Just got to go home now. I'm going to be off by 5. So yeah, I've got the profiles up. It's fucking hell. Anyway, check it out. Anyway, profile's on. So I'll see you tomorrow. So, it's Monday night. I'm just doing a bit of editing because it's going to be a long episode, this, so. I think Dean's texted me. Looks like it's going to be a solo week. He's off all this week, but I'm pretty much all loaded out. I've got everything sort of maxed out, loaded. I can't really get any more bricks on the scaffold or blocks on the floor because there's only a limited amount I can load out. So, gonna see how I go about this week solo. I'm probably using probably minimum of 2 tubs, and I'll probably use 3 tomorrow because I've got a lot of brickwork to run in. All my profiles are set in advance, like you've seen. That saves massive amounts of time. Obviously, the way I can get the mortar into the tubs, you know, 5 black tubs is half a proper tub of mortar. So I only have to do 2 refills, you know, or 1 refill after I fill up the tubs once, and that's 1 tub gone. And it really works well with sort of 5 black tubs, lay all the gear you can, empty them, then point up, sponge off or brush. I've been using brushes and sponge. I find the sponge works a little bit better, but it's dying on me, the sponge, and I don't think I've got any more. So I'll just probably have to use the brush tomorrow. It makes just as neat a job, really. I think you just need to get a little bit more of a brush. But I do like the sponge. It gives a nice finish, and it sponges off the smudges as well, which I like. But I think I'll keep using it until it's died its death. I think I could get another day out of it a bit. So yeah, we'll go about that. We'll try 1,000 brick solo tomorrow. I don't think I've done 1,000 brick solo yet, but I think it's today's going to be the day. I've got a 300 brick sort of panel ready to run in, and then I reckon I could probably do it with 3 tubs of mortar. Just I have to fill the last one up. I might have to fill the last one up right to bollocks. So everything's loaded out. I never think how many stacks I've got. 6 down there, and then I've got another 6. That's easily a fact. Yeah, I could definitely do it. But yeah, it's the main thing when you're working on your own. A lot of people panic, a lot of people sort of stress on their own. But as you've seen, you know, there's easy ways about it with these tubs. You know, I definitely recommend them, even if you just get them out of your van for the days you're working without your labourer. Or, you know, they're good. And try out the little trials and all. You know, I'm using Marshall Town 1, but the Morris Tees, if you wanted to get one for a couple of quid, try them out, see what you think. Definitely worth the money. It's you see, you know, how quick can do things with him. But yeah, right, I'm not gonna elongate this. I'll see you tomorrow. Right, it's 5 past 8. It's Tuesday. 1,000 brick solo day. Check it out. Here's my setup. Since Dean's not in, I'm running in his little section. So then we're gonna work his way out as we go. So right, see you in a bit. So guys, it is 10:30, just gone 10:30. Got that first panel in, I'm on my second tub now. So I'm doing pretty good for time, to be honest. You know, if I got here every day at this time, I'd probably earn a lot more money, but, you know, circumstance. There's always more time. Always more years to be working. I've got another 40 years of getting here early. So, anyway, check it out. So, it's my next tub. I've got this first tub, we're a bit wet to be honest, and it all disappeared in holes in brick, but I'm on this little section now. I think this is about a 20 brick section, I think. Got a little tail out round here. Perps are a bit big on this front, but nothing we could do about that. And then go around here, 6. I'm just tailing out 7 just to get me 13. And then I think they're bringing me some banding bricks so I can get that gable up for scaffold, but we'll see. Right, let's crack on and get this other tub used before I'm going to call 1 o'clock, 1:30 maybe. Right, see you in a bit. So it's 2:30 and we got that other panel done. Check out what we're up to. I've got to leave at 5, so I've got 2.5 hours to use this tub up, which I should do. And got another 300 or 400 brick panel to run in. I don't think I'll do it all, just because I'm feeling a bit tired now. This is starting at 8, being on scaffold at 8 and not having a edit, rather having a break, because I just thought I'd power it through, have a kind of Red Bull. But yeah, this is the other panel. So total brick count is probably at about 800 so far. That's with that big back panel, this panel here, and then we'll run this in. So we might we'll do over 1,000 definitely, but we'll see. I'll have a count up at end of day. Great guys. See you. I've got to get some Ebcam for you guys now. So, right, see you in a bit. Right, let's run this in. This profile, I don't think is plumb, so it's only tailored for a line. I can't use it as a stop end. I think I'm gonna have to plumb it up. Let's check. Wobbly as fuck. Yeah, it's miles out. I can't get it back. Can't get it back plumb. Therefore, I just tried my best. So I'm gonna have to plumb that side. That one's all right. Fucking hell, he's fucking. It's the only thing we've. That needs a bit of fucking. Brick tie behind it, but it's already got fucking 2 brick ties behind it. Set this bit. It's another bit of brick tie. Four bits of brick tie behind that one in 3 course. That's what you get sometimes when you take over houses. Well, it's plumb at least. 4 bits of brick tie behind fucking 1 brick, and it's clamped to 3 course of brick. Oh well, fuck it. Be right. I'm gonna clean them gutters out tomorrow because I've not dropped much down, so it'll be all pretty good. That's the one thing with traditional and these big bricks with holes, with these semi-engineerings with holes in, massive holes, so your gobbo just don't come out the back, the strollers come out the front. So oh yeah, I don't think I'll use that other quarter I've got left. I've got like quarter of a tub. Shit, I feel like I put that brick too far across. No, it's be a dry joint probably. Yeah, just a dry joint. Oh. Get me a big level. It's pretty level, that, which I'm happy about. I always use my small level. You see people trying to put big levels up, it's just a waste of fucking energy. So that's, you can see, when off the last fucking brick was laid. Yeah. So get that fucking tap. Get another plum. That's all you can go off really in your first course. Just go off your last course that was laid. Set your cavity to your last course. Away you go. And then this level is just, I think, a bit long, but you can still let range, just have to tap, pull you back in, make sure it's not bowed out at the profile. There we go, sorted. Well, trays are clean anyway. And these bits I dropped in. It's faster to lay traditional, or I call it spec mix, the spec mix style I call it, because that's what, this is the way they break all the records in competitions, competition style you can call it. It's fast, probably the fastest way to lay traditional, no grooves. And then we'll see what these perps work like over these. Let's have a look here. A bit of tweaking over this first course. So we got 3, 6, 9, 3, 6, 9. Actually, should all work bricks if I follow the soldiers. There we go. That's key with these bricks, getting full joints on them. They're a bastard to point and they smudge like fuck. So when I'm low down, I like to spread facing the same way I'm laying, and then when I get higher up, I turn to the side. Try to put your perp on fucking as vertical as you can, as vertical, straight up from the brick, so then it fills it. Obviously without it falling off. It makes me laugh on videos where people say, oh, look at size of the perps, look at size of the perps. Well, if that's actually set out, that's what you've got to follow. And that's the way of the world. There's a lot of guys who comment who aren't bricklayers on. So now I've got to open all these perps because it's going to work bigger perps. So I'll open this up. There might be 12, 30 mil perps, but you could tell a lot of guys commenting aren't bricklayers. Just saw their own upset people. There's a lot of upset
upset people in the world. They all leave comments on my videos. But yeah, I do get some supportive ones, you know, the same few guys who keep really positive. Thanks a lot for the support on Insta and all. A lot of guys leave us private messages and stuff there, which is really good, because sometimes the guys don't want to leave comments saying, you know, thanks a lot for, you know, because all you get is people just take piss out of them, so appreciate the private messages. Didn't fucking check my fucking gauge at that side. Did I fuck? Let's check it. Or did I? I did. I just thought it was a big bed. Well, that's worked pretty well. Got my soldiers. Oh, that's gone. Dean loaded out majority of these. This plot should be back next week sometime, hopefully. Just taking a bit of an holiday. Which I'm still waiting for some of my scaffolds and stuff anyway, so I reckon I've got half a day tomorrow on the brick, and then because I'll probably on get that corner around and then finish this little bit, because I want to get this finished and start doing some block corners, and I think I've at least got 3 days on the block solo, so that'll get me into next week. And then if I lose a day with him putting a roof on or something with crane, or even if I'm carrying gobble up a ladder or something, because there's going to be inevitable at this at some point. And then one of my plots might be freed up with a scaffold, hopefully. So here, because this is out of plumb, use what part you can. So still use the line, because the line's level as so, but we just plumb this side now. It's hard because you've got to look at the level at this side, but just get a plumb, and then when it goes off tomorrow, it's very good because I can't really get my levelling. I'd normally cut myself a bit of lat for this distance, but when I get up here, it won't matter. I'll be able to get my level across. So then I can take them F clamps off and clamp it to my corner that I've built. But I'm not going mega high with that corner. I'm not tailing it around. So I have to angle that brick over that bit of brickwork that we're out of square. You know, you ain't got to fucking sometimes stress so much about what's below, as long as it's, you tweak it, tweak your joint it nice neatly, make anything look nice. Some people kick off and whatnot. I've had, you know, I try not to kick off normally. Oh, that's fucking at middle at gauge mark, so that is very awkward, Harry. So, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So when it's like this, I just measure it with a tape measure. It's quicker actually. I'm trying to mess about. So that's 150. Okay, there's a wasp there. A wasp. Fuck off, wasp. Now this is one below, I think. and boil the gauge marks, so. So what I tend to do as well when I'm on my own is I'll tail out, say, two bricks now, so. And it just breaks up, spreading your sand too thin with dry bricks, so. Oh, once I've got my first course set, I'm going to try it works bricks. My first one up to the profile, and then I'll go two out, so. So, two bricks out. See what the joints are like. Yeah, they're pretty, like 30mm joints, more like that. And with clay bricks as well, because we're on clay. These are clay, and they're all going to vary in size somewhat. Just the way they're made. So, a little cheapo level. So, and now, obviously, we go off the first course we just laid, so we don't go off what's below, so that'd be out. There we go. Now, I've only tailed out two bricks, and I'll run in a bit of straight, and then I can tail out a little bit later. Do a little bit of freehand, a little bit of running in, but then I can really focus on getting some meat in at this time, 2:45. So yeah, the Marshalltown's ideal. My handle's just getting a little bit short now. Might try a W Rose one because it's also solid forged. The handle's bigger and I can always chop a bit of it off actually if I don't like it. So it's probably what I'm going to try next. They're a bit expensive, but Christmas is coming up. Might get a W Rose tile setter. It's expensive for what it is, but I don't think the Roses wear down as quick as the Marshalltowns. Given the steel does feel very similar, it feels a little bit more WHS-y. Plus get a wooden handle one, and then probably chop it down a little bit when it gets, or let it wear down, see what it, I have to chop a bit off with circular saw. Because to be honest, you don't need any bigger than 7. I get a little bit of pain there, that's where it's starting to get a bit rough. I might smooth that off with something. I cleared my garage out, but I'm going to get a DeWalt grinder. But until then, I want to try and get a W Rose anyway to add to the collection. We've got two lots of trays there. We've got meter box trays. They'll need to be cleaned out at some point because I'll not be able to. Take some blocks out of something whenever we take over this. It's so much for tapping cavities on another person's plot, but we'll see. These are bigger perps. Can you forget? There we go. Seen people online fucking putting the thumb inside the holes and stuff for laying perforated bricks, so there's no need. Lay it just like any other brick, just with your fingers on the edges of it. I think people find them a bit difficult to lay, but it's about mortar consistency per each type of brick. Like the other bricks on the site need different consistency mortar, and it's the time of year is completely different, temperature. Just got to take note. take note, and it takes a while to get used to a brick and all. If you only want to be on a job for a couple of good 3-4 weeks laying the same type of brick. So this is the, what's this, the second house we're doing with these. So sort of got, we've cracked it after the second lift, you know, sort of the second, we've done one first lift in these, and now we're on to another lift, another, what, a lift of these. So just chip, throw them out, a bit more wastage, and then because we've got a same again with these, being out of plumb. Pretty hefty joints on this front. Do open them up top a bit more. See what I mean about the key on the back of these bricks as well. It fills the joint a bit better at the back, and don't drop as much gobbo because the key helps it stick. So come round, I'll just square this little bit up. What I ran in the other day. That's fucking bang on. That's nice and level to my profile. That's why I know everything's running nice and level. Gauge profiles. So now, let's pull this up. Corner brick. That's off the profile. And then, bit of range action. There, it's near enough. Pull that up as well. Pull that up to the last course, first course I ran in. Yeah. There you go. So when I'm measuring every course now, I go 74. So if I go 74 or 73.5. That will normally give you an overall of the actual gauge, so it's a little bit low there, but you normally pick up a little bit every time. So back over here. Up more control with a small trowel as well, you drop less mortar, you know, but you still if there's a tray there, it's gonna get mortar in it no matter what you do. I remember a guy years and years ago on Stone Houses, and he said that he hadn't tapped his trays all the way around over a full hour, so it only had fucking 3 inch of gobble in bottom. But then I looked at the back of his stone and he hadn't scraped any of his snots up, so that was why it was all still up back at stone. That was funny, that really funny. There's no gobble in my tray because I hadn't scraped any snots off. Bosh. Straight up. Yeah, fucking hell. Sandstone's good to lay, but it fucking hurts me back because it's awkward. You can't lift it up very well. Yeah, I'd rather lay brick any day. Brick's now worth a lot more than stone. You know, normally stone's the same square meter as brick, but a lot of time now, brick's more per square meter than stone. But people used to like to lay stone because you get it down faster. If you watch Morgan the Builder, I think he does a lot of stone. But I haven't watched any of his videos for ages. There's a few guys who do videos I don't keep up, to be honest now. What's this brick here? What's that on for? Right, this one needs to be bigger now because this perp's, these perps are bigger. I hope you guys can see all right on the cam. I was meant to, I've downloaded the app for my GoPro, but I've not got it connected up yet. So as long as you get organised well, and like with these tubs, it makes working solo fucking a dream, to be honest. There isn't any problem working solo on any lift with tubs. You have the volume and water at your disposal at all times. You just have to be quick enough to use it. So the slower you are, I'd recommend just working out of three tubs if you're just sort of average speed. I'm working out of five, but just work out of two or three and just build corners all day. That's what I recommend if you were solo. And you're not very quick, because not everyone's going to be able to run in like a 30 brick run at once without going off too quick. So just focus on building like 12 course corners, or 13 course corners, whatever, with your profiles, and just, you know, little bits at a time. But over a full day, you know, you still do a lot, and that's without anyone. Sorry about that, my fucking GoPro died. There's only probably only get another 5 minutes of footage or 10 minutes of footage, only got 20%, so but yeah, I should probably really have the tub down here while I'm working, but I still like standing up. I still like it. I've tried it on the floor and I get a little bit of relief when I get to spread the bed for a couple of sec, you know, for a minute or so. Just take, it's just a lot to move the bins out of the way and stuff like that. Just want to minimise your time, not late, you know, when you're not laying. Doing other than things than laying. Yeah, but this site is the closest I've worked to home since I was on those, since I was doing that retaining wall, and my top knot and big beard. That was also very close to my house and all that job. So, now, obviously I've got to now lay off the profile again. Is a ball eight because I just want to lay against it, but because I can't get it plumb, that's what I'm gonna have to, what I'm having to do. Which it feels so weird not laying up to it. I could put a bit of lat up actually against the scaffold, but fuck that. I kept hitting my head on it the other day. And if you saw yesterday's clips, I had a fucking bit of lat attached to the scaffold to stabilize the profile. It's just a fucking top clamps and shit like that, and timber clamps and stuff. If you're only, you know, if it's just a lot of extra kit to carry around. I don't know. I've tried it multiple times using timbers and stuff, and it just takes longer to set up than it's worth doing. That's why a little bit of brick band behind the profile. I know it's old school, but it's independent and. You know, it's fucking, it just works for now. It works. Until we find something better. Pump this up. See how this was to the old brickwork. That's not too bad. Either. Yeah, it's not a good, it's not very good what I'm doing here. It's not ideal, but I'm gonna make it work. because I'm going to take some of my, probably once I've joined up after six course or so, I'll take them clamps off and then readjust them. I'll try to anyway, but probably just keep racking back now, match up with that and then rack back. Again, bits of fucking shit on the profile. See how wobbly it is, guys. It'll do for another course or two, and then we'll get a reclamp. So I'm only tailing around here a little bit, so. I've got a tub here and it's getting unused. Oh, we're not doing too bad for time. 3:10. I always set my watch fast as well, so I'm ahead of the game. This 1,000 brick a day solo video, it's not, just takes working, it takes just working non-stop for, you know, 9 hours, having like an hour total time not laying. It's just about numbers, really. It's about getting numbers down, that's all it is, just building your tolerance up to be able to work a lot of hours without stopping. But that's why you have to make it easy, because you can't be working hard for that long, that amount of time. You've got to be making, you know, working smart. People tell me how fucking slow they are, but yet they only work fucking, you know, how slow I am and how fast they are, and then they work fucking 4.5 hours a day, 5 hours a day. Why not work a bit more efficient, a bit more smarter, and work 8 hours and then effectively, you know, double or whatever. Oh, we earn this much, our gang earns this much, but yet, you know, it's not about, it's just about efficiency. Alas says, aka Mel, Alas says I need to be more efficient at home. Starting to hurt there where I've been tapping like that. They're starting to hurt my hand, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my glove out, which I've left around there. It's starting to hurt my hand a bit, and I have to go to wearing gloves. Here it is, here's my glove. Don't like, I used to wear gloves all the time, but I try not to now, but definitely gonna have to go back to, have to wear gloves now. It's no big deal. These Manipulo ones are quite good. They keep your hands warm in winter anyway. It makes the trowel handle feel a little bit thicker, so. Oh god, with the perp size here, I'm running out of more quick. A bit more padded, not scraping much. I'm going to make a bit slightly bigger trowel for these tubs, mainly for block work. But saying that, you don't need that much mortar per block, so I don't think there's much that can beat this at the moment. You can see as well how I've been laying, I've not been putting a lot of pressure on my thumb, so my gloves aren't worn through either. So it's, you know, a lot of it is not putting too much mortar. And I'd say that's one thing you do probably more with pick and dip, is you're not moderating the amount of mortar you're putting on, so you're putting more wear on your hands than vice versa your arms throughout a day. So I don't think you can beat the spec mix style for ease on these type of massively perforated bricks, which they tend to use in the spec mix. They do use these type of bricks. So put a brick on here now, off the profile once again, which is really triggering me, and we'll plumb it. Here's my big level now. So going from there, so let's plumb down. So we need to pull that out there a bit. That's set. So now, put a perp joint on, 20 miller, there we go, and then, once that's set, go back, and even these out, still big perps though. Do not pick and dip very well at all, these bricks, so I've not really been pick and dipping. But it hasn't really affected the speed, it's just about laying in the right way. Try to get your snots while they're fresh so they don't drop off. That's another thing. People in the comments are just like, Harry's fucking cavity's a fucking shit. I'll be like, well, suck it. So now I've squared this up, I will now wrap back here, and then I can get my level in easier. See, that was loads of goblin, that's nowhere near enough. So fill in the perp in. There we go. That's why we've got to lose a bit in the internal. The perps are big, make sure it's right on the internal, even them out. My specialty, losing fucking halves in internals. So that's what pots I seem to get given. Ones with three quarters in and halves. This one ain't got any in, so I'm happy. So, I should really get some decent levels, but too busy buying fucking cheap trowels. Same again, let's come down from where we started, and then range through. It's pretty good, that. Just render up this little front bit here of the door, and there's a little canopy, but it didn't even show soldiers on the drawing, so they've put soldiers over it. So they've got soldiers. God, that's moving like fuck. Right, we're gonna put one more course to it. I'll put one more course to this wiggly wobbly profile and then we're gonna reset it. See what we do with it. This one's solid. It's been a good day for laying today. It's been a good day. Not had this good a day in a long time. Well, just that 1300 on them Connie bricks, but then someone watching over me there saying, yeah, well, you're not having that. Not having that, we're gonna fuck you up. And then I ate nothing the week after that. So, effectively, whatever I ate that week was halved. But it'd be nice to get on some block work actually after all this brick. It's a bit tiring just laying on thousands of bricks. You do 1,000 bricks a day, you don't like necessarily want to lay bricks the next day, you'd fancy doing a block. But I think they want me to, they've got another 7 course spot, not the game, because if they've got some banding bricks arrive, then I'd be tempted to take all the brickwork up first. But I like my piers to be supported with some windows, and I like to at least go my block to frame height, and then I can sort of put my frames in. And I can clean my cavities, I can take some blocks out to clean my trays. Because I've even checked all the vents are in on this house. They all got put in at joist lift. Well, yeah, joist lift, second lift. So no vents to put in. So I just get it to sill height and then go from there really. Get some of the meat of the block work out of the way. I'm gonna put big corners on my middle wall as well, so I've still got access to all my house. Middle wall will be running last. Some beam filling to do and stuff. Well, that took another 3 days to do that. And I've got a 5k I'm gonna run tonight, a steady one though. So I'm not eating, so. Oh. Right, it's 4:45. I'm done finally. I'm sort of about 1100 brick here. There's 1,000 just in the straight bits with a couple of bricks around the corner, but I've done quite some elongated tail outs on the brickwork, so I'll quit 1100 just to be safe. But yeah, check it out. I've got 3 course. From Banda on this other panel, so I've just got like half a day probably tomorrow doing the rest of the brickwork until I get some contrasting bricks. But yeah, check it out. There we go. That's all. What we got done today is, I'll show you, I'll take you on a little tour. So I started down here yesterday dinner time. I only used one tub in the afternoon, and then this morning filling that panel. And then this is what I've done this afternoon, all this little panel here, and then this is what we did before we went for dinner. This here. So yeah, these are probably the worst brick. Everyone says these are the worst brick on the job, so this smudge, but I still get 1100 down sal low in a day. 800 sal. You know, can bricklayers earn £800 in a day? I say yes, but you know, it's not everyone will. You know what I mean? It takes a lot of. Anyway, I'm not bang on. Right, I'm gonna go get my young'un from nursery. Right, see you in a bit. Oh, hold on, I went here. Okay. Bye, lads.
So, I'm off for a 5K now. Obviously doing that 1100 today will have obviously took some off my time, but that's one thing I like to emphasise. I'm like 8 week sober, 9 week I'm back running like I used to be. Fitness has a lot to do with what you can get done at work, whether you knacker out quick and whatnot. Obviously your age and all, I'm 27, so. But yeah, I'm going to go hit a 5K, no filming obviously, but it's dark. But I've got my head torch on and my Ivy's, but my other running t-shirts are washed. So anyway, right, see you in a bit. Sub 35K, post 1100 bricks, I will. It's got to be a world record. Over 100 kilo, should I say. Jesus Christ. About 110 I had this morning. Fucking hell. Right, I'll get some alcohol-free beers. Stuff my face. See you in a bit.